Hi everybody, and I'm here to do a really quick video about being positive. And the reason why I want to put this video out there is because I used to do this and I'm really stopping myself from doing this, and I wanted to share this with you guys. That I'm the kind of person who loves hard. Like, if I love you, if you're part of my family, if we're together in a relationship, if I consider you a close friend or whatever, I just love you to death. I really do. And I noticed that when I love people, that I tend to love too much. And I know that you're just like, how can you love somebody too much? Well, you can. You don't even realize it, but you can love somebody too much. And that being said, like, it would always hurt me when, you know, if I love somebody, I always, no matter how strange it sounds, no matter how crazy it is that they do or they like and stuff, I'm like, okay, because I love you, then I'm down. I get what you're trying to do. If somebody's like, oh my God, I love Star Wars and Star Wars is my thing, I'm like, okay, tell me a little bit about Star Wars. I've heard of Star Wars, but what is it about? What do you like about it? You know, and I try to really get in and encourage them those things if it's positive. Now, stuff that's negative, I'm just like, you gotta go. But if it's positive, I'm like, okay, well, what is it? What do you like about it? How can, you know, you incorporate me into what you like? Because I like to experience and see new things. But it doesn't always work in reverse. It's always that if I like something, then it doesn't matter who it is. Somebody that I'm with, family members, friends, people around me, they just don't get it. As much love as I would put out there, I wouldn't always receive that back. And I'd be so confused. I'd be like, well, maybe, you know, they really don't, you know, maybe the love's not really there, or, you know, maybe it's me, or, you know, stuff like that. I'd be really hurt by it, because I would say as much positive, you know, that I would send out into the universe, some of that positive was not coming back to the people, coming back from the people that I was so positive to. And it's really important that you have to separate those emotions away from everything, because I would be so upset. Like, okay, I love Marie Antoinette days. If it's Marie Antoinette, King Louis the 16th, the Duchess of Dachau, the Duchess of Polignac, who else? I can't even think right now, but if it's all that, Jane Austen, Pride and Prejudice, Sense and Sensibility, Emma, you know, all that stuff, I just love. And I love from, it would probably have to be from Jane Austen days to the Harlem Renaissance. So Harlem Renaissance, New York, I love, 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 love. All the way back to Marie Antoinette, France, and Jane Austen, England. That's it. Not Jane Austen days, America. Jane Austen days, England. Marie Antoinette, France. Harlem Renaissance, New York. And I love it. I love the music. I love the way that they dressed. I love the protocol. You know, people in my phone are even under rank. I put people in rank. So, like, my aunt is the queen, and then under her granddaughter is the dauphine, because she's next in line for the throne. Because I'm the oldest, I put myself as the dauphine, the next in line for the throne of my castle. And then everybody else, the same thing. Like, there's Comtesse, there's let me just go through my phone really fast, because I have a lot. Let me see. Okay, I have dauphins, comtesse, baronesses, barons, princesses of the blood, counts, archduchesses, dames, the dauphins, the queens, archduchess, lady-in-waitings. It's crazy, but I love it, and that's what I love. So when people, you know, that are really close to me just don't understand, and they just like, oh my god, that's so stupid, or whatever like that, before, I would be like, oh my god, I can't believe that you would even say something like that to me. Like, you know, as much support as I put out there, it just doesn't come back. But now, I just don't care. Now I'm just like, okay, you want to think it's like that? Go ahead. Doesn't matter who it is. Doesn't matter if, you know, it doesn't matter. Because I know what, like, it's positive, and that it's, you know, coming out there, and that I put out positive. So, for everybody else out there, I just hope that you guys don't do the thing that I used to do and just go and be like, oh, well, I can't believe that they said that. I'm going to retract, and, you know, I just won't listen to that kind of stuff, or not listen to it, but I just won't, you know, be as, you know, much into it in the open, and I'll just be a closet person. And that's how I was. I loved a lot of things, and then people just didn't understand that. So then I would just be like, well, you know, when people ask what I like, I said a little bit of stuff, but I wouldn't say that stuff. And I love Japan's culture. I love geisha. There's a lot of stuff that I really like, and I would put that stuff on the back burner, and then people would be like, well, what do you like? And I'd be like, well, and I would always say the things that I liked, but that just were like mainstream. And then all the other stuff that I would like, I just keep it on the back burner, keep it in the closet. And I'm just telling everybody out there that you shouldn't be like that. You should just love all the things that you like. It doesn't matter who says what about it. It doesn't matter how they feel about it. You just like it. And if they love you enough to like the things that you like and be around the things that you like, then so be it. But if not, then it just was not meant to be. And that's just how my motto is for 2012, because 2012 is coming, and 2011 really sucked. It really did. It just was not the best year. I've had really good years, like really, really good years, and 2011 was not one of them. They were in the top five probably worst years, and the year's not even done. But I see where a lot of my problems, you know, where they laid, because it was me. A lot of the times people don't want to say it was me. A lot of the times people will be like, well, this person did this, and this person did that, and they did, and da 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 da. It was me. It was actually me. And now I feel like I'm just, you know, grasping a bunch of things that I just did not grasp before, and I'm really letting go of all the things that, you know, before would make me upset. Now they just don't even make me upset. Like, I love hard, and, you know, I'm the kind of person who wants love. I love love, and, like, if somebody's not giving me love, then they just have to, you know, be pushed aside and just be like, okay, if you're not gonna give me love, there's, you know, besides Jesus Christ up above, there's somebody who's gonna give me love. If it's not you, then there's no way that I'm not gonna have love in my life, period, you know. And I feel that way about family, friends, significant others, everything. Like, it's just, I just feel like if I'm coming out of that, like, to where before I would be like, I don't know, like this little scared like puppy dog, and be like, oh my god, like, you know, whatever I need to do to make my family stay together, whatever I need to do to make, you know, my significant other, you know, better, whatever I need to do to fix our relationship, whatever I need to do to stay friends with people and do all this other stuff. And then now it's like, that's my problem, not theirs, because I'm enabling them. So now I'm just like, I'm not doing it. I'm not enabling anybody. I'm not doing all this other stuff, but I'm staying positive. Even though people you know, are not the same positive or keeps that positivity, you know, towards me, I still give positive back. And I know to some people that sounds strange, but you want to get used to being positive all the time. You want to get used to being around the stuff that you like, being positive, putting it out there, killing people with kindness. There's a bunch of people who just cannot stand me. That's fine. You know, you can't stand me, that's okay. But I'm not going to be upset with you or be mad at you, you know. A lot of people, they, you know, a lot of people have done me wrong, and, you know, I just send them a message and leave them alone. There's been some times where I do feel vindictive, like I just want to hit you where it hurts, like you did me, but in the end, it's not even worth it. It's not. And I hope that you guys really do the same, or take something from what I said and put it in your everyday life, because that's really going to make a difference in your life. It's really going to make a difference when you start being more positive and putting things out there and putting positive out into the universe. So I hope you guys do that, and I will keep putting positive things on YouTube. Yes, I will. Not a negative Nancy. So I'll see you guys later.